Are you trying to decide between C# and Java? Are you proficient in one and would like to know how it compares to the other one? Are you trying to decide which one to learn? Hi, it's Chuck here with another language comparison video. Yeah, that's right, I'm gonna go there. Judging from some of the comments on my last comparison video, some viewers apparently feel like I insulted their spouse. Now, I've been designing and implementing applications for nearly 4 decades, and I like curly brace languages, in particular C++, Java, and C#. And I really enjoy coding in all of them. This comparison is simply to help you make an informed decision. First, there's a basic difference in philosophy. Java architect James Gosling insisted on inventing a simple language when it came to Java back in the mid-90s, early 90s. Capabilities would be built into class libraries and tools. Java has roughly 50 keywords or so, reserve words, so relatively small language compared to most other languages. C#, on the other hand, has over 100 keywords and contextual keywords and many more syntactical features. A driving force behind C# philosophically is to minimize code size and eliminate tedious or boilerplate code. So you can kind of think of it like C# is like a luxury vehicle with every bell and whistle. No need for any aftermarket or add-ons because everything is already on it. Java, on the other hand, is kind of like a stripped-down Jeep or Volkswagen Beetle with thousands, literally thousands of third-party add-ons, and you can configure whatever you want. Now, Gosling and Oracle parted ways back in 2010, and since then, Oracle has added some new bells and whistles to Java and kind of standardized some of the third-party items so that configuration and building applications is a little bit more straightforward and simpler. But it's still a smaller, simpler language with an enormous ecosystem of third-party tools. At the same time, Microsoft, with the introduction of .NET Core, has opened up to encourage more third-party componentry. Now, let's start with what they have in common. They both compile to an intermediate code and execute within a runtime. They both have run anywhere capability. They're both strongly typed. They're both object-oriented languages with a single base class called object, and they're limited to single inheritance. Both have value type primitives and primarily reference-based as far as the rest of your variables are concerned. They both support generics, they both support functional programming, and include lots of metadata in the binaries to support dynamic applications. In fact, this class will compile in either language. Properties in Java are supported through a programming convention of setter and getter functions. On the other hand, C# has a specific syntax for properties. So we could recode that class for C# specifically, creating designated properties. Now, a lot of cases in properties in our code, the properties are trivial, simply exposing some backing field. In that case, C# provides us even a more concise syntax called auto properties. Now, another subtle but significant difference is that Java primitives are not objects. If you need to treat a primitive as an object, you have to use a wrapper class to make that primitive appear as a reference type, as an object type. For instance, like in a generic parameter. In C#, the primitives are simply aliases for .NET types, and all .NET types are derived from objects. C# supports the definition of both value types and reference types using either struct or class, and both are first-class citizens, and both can be used as generic parameters. C# primitives can also be declared as nullable using language syntax, the question mark. Now, we can do the same thing in Java using the class optional or the generic optional. So you see what I mean? C# provides a syntax for a feature, while Java accomplishes the feature via some class. Now, speaking of type specifiers, Java has 3, class, enum, and interface. C# has several. It has class, interface, and enum, and it also has struct, record, delegate, and an implicit dynamic type, basically a tuple. Now, Java supports the concepts of record and tuple, but again, it's done via classes. Value and reference type semantics in Java is fixed. In other words, the primitives are value types, classes are reference types, and there's no changing that. In C Sharp, you can choose whether a value type is passed by reference or passed by
value.
And in C Sharp, you can define using struct value types and using class reference types. Now, I think one of the most significant differences is that C Sharp supports operator overloading. This means that the programmer can use standard comparison operators to compare any object type that defines those operators. This is a common pitfall for Java developers because the equality operator, double equal, is syntactically legal, which compares the references, not the values. Java developers are reminded to call the .equals or .compare methods. Both languages support functional programming and lambda expressions. Java basically repurposed the single abstract method interface and called that a functional interface, while C Sharp has a type definition called a delegate to define a function signature to use in functional callbacks or functional definitions. Java also supports events, event triggering, and subscription, but again, just like the properties, it does that through naming conventions. C Sharp has a dedicated keyword and a dedicated syntax for eventing. Now, there is also a difference in exception handling. Java initially promoted the concept of checked exceptions, making a programmer to declare the exception types that might emit from the method. However, in C Sharp, there is no mechanism for that. You couldn't do it if you wanted to. The trend in C++, and actually even in Java, is to move away from checked exceptions in most situations. Some Java frameworks, like Spring, for instance, catch the checked exceptions and rethrow unchecked exceptions. Checked exceptions sounded like a good idea at the time, but ended up really making code more brittle. Now, there are subtle differences in how things work under the hood, and we don't want to get too specific here because every version, the runtimes change, and so we don't want to get into that too deep. Java's garbage collection initially was optimized for desktop applications and therefore was lazy. There was no need to clean up memory allocations if the application wasn't going to live very long anyway. While .NET utilized what's called a generational garbage collection scheme, that's more well suited for server-based applications. Oracle did introduce generational garbage collection for Java starting in version 8. All right, now generics are also handled differently. Java compiles generics using object as the template parameter and enforces the type safety in the application code at compile time. So there, in reality, there's only one instance of any generic class. C Sharp generates a new type for each generic variant. Now, this only really matters if your code is using reflection to determine a type at runtime. Now, another big difference between Java and C Sharp is something called Language Integrated Query, or LINQ. This is a feature in C Sharp that allows us to create queries against any kind of data set, a collection, an in-memory collection, or any ADO.NET database driver, honestly, can be used. It's accomplished through some features in C Sharp called extension methods. Java does not have extension methods. Now, I hate to bring this up because there are so many variables that it's really hard to measure with any certainty. I promise you, any programmer can get the answer they want to get, but here we go anyway. I just ran a very simple, unscientific, CPU-intensive loop to calculate pi. The C Sharp version ran at about 400 milliseconds, and the Java version took just under twice as long, about 750 milliseconds or so. Now, don't read too much into that, and don't get excited, Java programmers. We used to have a saying back in the late 90s, you know, Java developers would ask about performance. And I'd say, why all of a sudden you become concerned about performance? You're using Java, aren't you? It's fast enough. And the same thing's true with C Sharp. It's fast enough. If you really want blazing speed, go code in C++. Most applications aren't all that performance critical? In determining performance, though, if you are really trying to measure that, you have to consider a lot of other factors like network and database speed. Both platforms handle threading and multi-core architecture and all that kind of stuff really well. From little things like implicit variable types with the var keyword to bigger things like functional programming, the programmer experience is really pretty similar. If the Java developer can step into an existing technology stack, then they can start right out of the box, just like the .NET developer. There are some scenarios that favor one over the other. Let's say that I need to build something that's going to really easily deploy and run anywhere. I would choose Java. The .NET Core platform was also run anywhere, but it's not quite as easy to do. If I need to develop a phone application for the iPhone or for Android, I would choose C# on Xamarin or Maui. It's also a better choice for game development, like under Unity. Otherwise, it really doesn't make that much difference. Choose based on your existing developer resources. All right, I'm sure I ruffled some feathers. Why don't you give it to me in the comments section? Make sure you hit the like button. Make sure that you tell your friends about this video and subscribe to our channel. That's how we can bring you more great content going forward. I'm Chuck McCullough. Thanks.